Good morning to everybody. I'm Maria Cristina Bustos. I am a researcher in Complex System Group, and I'm going to talk about the project I've been working on. It's called Pedestrian Safety in Complex Urban Scenarios. This project has been developed in collaboration with the Scene Understanding Group, among others. So, do you know that in Barcelona has 90,000 traffic accidents in the last 10 years? If you made the calculation, it's almost 20 accidents per day between pedestrians and car accidents. But accidents could be slight, only scratches with no people hurt, or huge fatalities. And in a city like Barcelona, where cars, bikes, pedestrians, and even scooters are sharing the same space, and we lately, with the massive people influence, the road safety left pedestrians as the most vulnerable population. So we are aware that accidents could be caused for multiple reasons. One of the reasons are distraction by technologies, alcohol consumption, weather conditions, high speed, ignoring traffic signs, among others. But in our project, we are going to study one of the reasons is the visual environment. It means there is something visually that urban circumposition that could increase this accident ratio. For example, occlusions, misplaced objects, scene density. So the objective of this project is, can we know which places in the city are more dangerous regards to pedestrian safety, but more specifically, can we run each place between safe or dangerous according only to the visual features? So for doing this, we are going to use an artificial intelligence method. It's called deep learning. Deep learning is a very successful technique that has solved many problems lately. But if you are not familiar with it, it's a large computational model that has a lot of parameters that needs to be trained according to a training data in order to predict an outcome. So in our case, we are going to feed this neural network with urban scenes and predict a dangerous score in order to pedestrian safety. So for doing this, we need training data. So first of all, we collect this data, extracting the geolocation coordinates of the roads inside the city. And with these coordinates, we have longitude and latitude. And with these coordinates, we can extract almost 1 million on images of urban scenes from cities like Barcelona and Madrid, and also for San Francisco. We extracted these images from Google Street View. And another service is called Mapillary. And also, we need to know where this accident data happens before. So also, we have the coordinates of the accidents, pedestrian accidents that happened before in the last 10 years for each city. So we can link these two data sources in order to build a training dataset of urban scenes that have been dangerous in the past, in order that our deep learning model learns the visual patterns of these urban scenes. So what does it mean? That when we have an artificial intelligence system that predicts how dangerous is an urban scene according to pedestrian safety. So as a result, we have mapped all these three cities regards to the dangerous score of pedestrians. So in Barcelona and Madrid, the most dangerous zones are in the center, but also we have other dangerous zones around the city. But in San Francisco, the dangerous zones for pedestrians are even less sparse. Also, we can zoom in some of these maps, and we can have a map of each street inside the city that indicates how dangerous is this point for pedestrians. For example, this is a map of the Poble Nou neighborhood in Barcelona. So it means that it doesn't matter if the streak has happened an accident before, but our artificial system can predict only based on the visual feature how dangerous it is. So more specifically, the artificial intelligence takes urban scene images and automatically score these images according to a danger score. So now that we know which points are dangerous, which one are not, how can we know which objects inside the image are influencing the most this dangerousness? So for doing this, we apply two deep learning techniques. One of these is image segmentation, that we take the urban scene, and can we know which objects are inside the urban scene and where they are. Also, we apply class activation mapping, that they highlight the region of the urban scene where it's more informative to the artificial system to get the danger score. So if we cross these two information, we can have an insight, a hint of how the urban scene looks when it's dangerous and when it's safe. For example, for dangerous urban scene, there are more people, nature, and building all together, and also vehicles in the same scene. So it means that it's more dense and disordered than the urban scene. For safest point, if it's more sky and more visualization on road, sidewall, or traffic objects, they indicate more clean scene. So we are going to know for each urban scene how can we make an intervention to make it safer. So we implement heuristic that we take one urban scene, we apply the segmentation and the class activation mapping, and then we remove this with these danger parts, and with the remaining, we find the most similar safe image. This is in order to know to understand how a dangerous urban scene will be look like if it's safer. So, for example, in this urban scene, if we remove this part where there are very dense objects, we can have 10% safer. And for example, in this urban scene, if we remove this little object that increase the interaction between pedestrian and cars, we can gain 8% in safetiness. But we can also make little intervention, like removing this sign, we can have 4% safer. But not all these changes are possible. For example, here the AI said to me, like, if you remove this building, you are going to gain 40%, but this is not possible. Okay, this is not possible. So, in general, we are studying how this safe scenes and dangerous scenes are. So, in general, we have a general outcome of urban scenes are more like, they are more even vegetation, also more visualization on the sky. But for Barcelona, it works more for pedestrian safety when the roads are narrow. But for Madrid and San Francisco, works that where it's wide road. So in this moment, we are working on this. We have a lot of future work, but we are preparing this project in order to have a listening intervention that urban planners can do for making a city safer. So thank you so much for your attention. If you have some questions, you can reach me later. Thank you.